Hi everyone, I am Dr. Purushottam D.N., Assistant Professor of Commerce. Let us begin with the session for the BCom third semester course. Subject entitled Indian Financial System. Educate ourselves about the objectives of the capital market. The capital market's authority aims to regulate securities activities in fair, transparent and efficient manner, grow the capital market, diversify and develop investment instruments thereof in accordance with best international practices, enhance investor protection, reduce systematic risk arising from securities activities, impose requirements of full disclosure in order to achieve fairness and transparency, and to prevent conflicts of interest in the use of the insider information, ensure compliance with the rules and regulations relating to the securities activities, enhance public awareness of and of the benefits, risks and obligations arising from investments in securities, and encourage their development. So these all are the common aim of the capital market. Now we are discuss one by one objectives of the capital market. Number one is capital formation. Capital formation by championing savings and making them available to companies and public authorities that need them. And the capital market offers to access to a variety of financial instruments that enables economic agents to price and exchange risk. It encourages savings financial reform process with attractive yields, liquidity and risk characteristics. Through the stock exchange, the market gives long-term lenders the opportunity to convert their holding into cash. It also offers companies which have securities the opportunity to obtain cash without reducing their liquidity. And the capital market plays an important role in the mobilizing of funds and resources needed for the development, and offers the forum of implementing its policies relating to stabilization, monetary controls and regulation of the banking system. In the eyes of the market regulation, the prime objectives of the capital market regulation is investors' protection, creative accounting, insider dealings and misuse of the client. Many are some of vices that investors needs to be protected from. Capital market regulation has its core objectives are protect investors, ensures that markets are fair and efficient and transparent, the reduction of systematic risk. So, regulation of the capital market is meant to protect the public interest, which operates on the need to promote economic development and confidence, which in turn should involve investment. It is a market for borrowing and lending of long-term finance, that is for a period of more than 1 year. The main types of instruments in the capital market are debentures, shares, government securities and bonds. There is a high degree of risk involved in the capital market as it involves long-term investments. Capital market is traded in two categories. One is primary market, another is secondary market. Primary market is known as the new issue market. Secondary market known as traded with the existing securities. And here borrowing and lending is for a period which is more than 1 year. Long-term financial instruments like share bonds are traded. That means capital market deals in long-term investments. Number two is bring together borrowers and lenders. It acts as a mediator between the borrowers and lenders of the money. It links person having surplus funds with the one who is the deficit of money. Capital market directs people having savings to different productive investment avenues. This helps in providing long-term funds to borrowers by attracting large investments from people. And it's regulated by the government. Capital market works as per the regulation of the There is a body named SEBI, Securities Exchange Board of India, set up by the government who looks and regulates the functioning of the capital market. It controls and monitors the functioning of the capital market to protect the interest of its investors. It aims at avoiding any speculative and malpractice in the capital market. Another one, the aim of the capital market is utilizes intermediaries. There are several intermediaries who are connected with the capital market to facilitate its functioning. Intermediaries are termed as important work organs of capital market. Different intermediaries involved with the capital market are broker, sub-brokers, underwriters, collection bankers, etc. These intermediaries interact with customers and communicate all important information between the capital market and customers. Another one role of capital market is, capital market reflects the rate of capital growth in the economy and circulates the funds among different sectors of the economy. It provides the huge fund required for the large infrastructure and industrial sector of the nation by attracting investments from the public, and different business corporations depend on the capital markets for raising funds for their processes. This way, it accelerates the rate of capital formation in the economy. And capital market provides liquidity. Capital market is a high liquid market as the instruments traded in the capital market are easily convertible into cash. Investors can, whenever they require, can convert their investment into cash by selling their instruments over the market. It provides an all-time market for the people who are looking for investment and one looking for the borrowing money. Next role of the capital market is variety of instruments. There are variety of instruments which are traded in the capital market. There is a lot of options available for both investors and borrowers, hence providing greater flexibility to both. A person, according to his risk-taking ability and convenience, can take any of the avenues available for investment and borrowing. And high leverage company can go for equity option for raising funds, whereas low leverage company can go for the debenture and bonds options. Next function of the or role of the capital market is, it includes primary market and secondary market. Capital market includes two markets within it, primary market and secondary market. Already we discussed about the primary market that deals with the new issue securities, and securities are issued for the first time, while in case of the secondary market, it is a market for old and existing securities, means securities already traded in the primary market or issued in the secondary market. So it gives some idea. In 1995, the finance minister spoke about the objectives of the capital and securities market in Lok Sabha in this way. The economic services which a well regulated and efficiently run capital market can render to a country with a large private sector are considerable. In the first place, it is only an organized securities market, means an integral part of capital market, which can provide sufficient marketability and price stability for shares, so necessary for the needs of investors, and impose requirements of full disclosures in order to achieve the fairness and transparency, and to prevent conflicts of interests and the uses of insider information. So, capital market ensures compliance with the rules and regulations related to the securities activities, and enhancing public awareness of securities activities, of the benefits, risk, and obligations arising from investments in securities, and encourage their development. Secondly, it is only such a market that can provide a reasonable measures of safety and fair dealing in the buying and selling of securities. Thirdly, through the interplay of the demand for and supply of securities, properly organized stock exchange assist in reasonable correct evaluation of securities in term of their real worth. Lastly, through the evaluation of securities, the stock exchange helps in the orderly flow and distribution of sales as between different types of competitive investments. Regulate securities activities in fair and transparent and efficient manner and advise to grow the capital market and diversify development investment instrument thereof in accordance with the best international practices. Enhance investment protection. Reduce systematic risk arising from the securities. These all are the decisions are taken by the Finance Minister of India in 1995. In the view of the financial transactions for long period, the capital market performs some functions. Number one is it acts as a link between savers and investors. Capital market functions as a link between savers and investors. It plays an important role in the mobilizing the savings and diverting them in the productive investments. In this way, capital market plays a vital role in transferring the financial resources from surplus and wasteful areas to the deficit and productive areas, so increasing the productivity and prosperity of the country. Number two, encouragement of savings. With the development of the capital market, the banking and non-banking institutions provide facilities which encourage people to save more in the less developed countries. In the absence of the capital market, there are very little savings. Who save often investment their savings in unproductive and wasteful directions, that is in real estate like land, gold, jewelry. Third function of the capital market is the capital market facilitates lending to businessmen and the government and thus encourages investments. It provides facilities through banks and non-bank financial institutions, various financial assets, example, shares, securities, bonds, etc. Induce savers to lend to the government or investment in industry. With the development of the financial institutions, capital becomes more mobile, interest rate falls and investment increases. Fourth function of the capital market is promotes economic growth. The capital market not only reflects the general condition of the economy but also accelerates the process of economic growth. Various institutions of the capital market like non-bank financial intermediaries allocate the resource rationally in accordance with the development of the country. The proper allocation of the resources results in the expansion of the trade and industry in the public and private sectors, thus promoting the balanced economic growth in the country. Fifth function of the capital market is stability in the security. Create the stability in the security prices. The capital market tends to stabilize the values of the stocks and securities and reduce the fluctuation in the prices to the minimum. The process of stabilization is facilitated by the providing capital to the borrowers at a lower interest rate and reducing the speculative and unproductive activities. Number six is credit market helps the investors. That means capital market helps to the investors to make the more profit. Investors, those who have funds to invest in the long-term financial assets in many ways, like it brings together the buyers and sellers of the securities and ensure the marketability of investments. By advertising securities prices, stock exchange enables them investors to keep track of their investments and channelize them into most profitable lines and safeguards the interest of the investors by compensating them from the stock exchange compensating fund in the event of the fraud and default.